Hello and welcome. You're watching Property Hotline with me, Kavita Krishnan, on India's first property business channel, Magicbricks Now. Are you planning to buy property? Are you confused about which location will fit your budget? Which project will suit your requirements? Today, we'll answer all your queries on buying, selling and investing property here. Our expert for the day is Surabhi Arora. Surabhi is the Associate Director, Research at Colliers India. Surabhi is joining us from Delhi. Welcome, Surabhi, to the show.
Thank you, Kavita.
So, Surabhi, let's get started. First up is a video query that is coming in from Sandeep Patil. Let's see what Sandeep has to say.
This is Sandeep calling from Vimannagar, Pune. So my first question is around this place, Vimannagar. So what kind of prospective in terms of price appreciation can I see 5 years down the line for this place? And my second question is around a place called Kamote in Navi Mumbai. I already own a property there that I have invested in 2010 and sitting pretty much on a decent price appreciation. So my question is, could I see more price appreciation or the prices will be stagnant in that area? I can hold this property for 5 more years. Thank you.
Right. So Surabhi, he's looking at Vimannagar and Kamote. He wants to know the prospects over a 5-year horizon. What would you say?
Okay, I will take Vimannagar first. Vimannagar is a quite mature market, and the rent, the capital value is already in the range of 8,000 to 10,000. As you are looking for a long-term investment for 5 years, I think it makes sense because the metro is planned in this area. But that metro will come in the next 5 years. So I think if your horizon is around 5 years, you can see a decent appreciation. This location has a very good mix of commercial, residential and retail. And it's very near to the airport also. So because of the lot of employment hub nearby and due to proximity to airport, this is a very good location for a 5-year horizon. But for in the short term, you will not see that much appreciation like a emerging market. So for a 5-year
Over a 5-year horizon, like you said, there is a metro coming up over here. So what kind of bump up in prices can you actually expect because of the metro?
See, because of the metro, generally the price appreciate in the range of 10 to 20% in an area. But the metro is in a pre-bidding stage right now. So you can expect that jump will not happen immediately, but surely when the metro will start, when the work will start, the area will grow up.
So pre-bidding stage, so you're being very, very optimistic here. So it's not 5 years, he should actually be looking at least 10 years, right? When you're talking pre-bid.
No, 5 years is a decent time.
Okay, let's move on. Let's talk about Kamote now. How do you see this location?
Yeah. Okay, Kamote is a established node in Navi Mumbai, and it has seen a good appreciation in last 3-4 years. The average appreciation is around 10-12% in this location for last 2-3 years. The prices have moved from 3,000 to 5,000 rupees a square feet. Currently, the properties are in the range of 5,000 to 6,000. So, in the short term, I can say okay, you will not see that kind of big appreciation. The appreciation will be in the range of 5 to 7% in this location. If you are holding this property for another 5 years, then I think it's a good investment bet.
So essentially, Surabhi, you would recommend that Sandeep hold both the properties for at least 5 years before taking a call and selling either one of them, right? Let's move on. Ashutosh Deshmukh has called in with his question. Ashutosh.
Yeah, I'm Ashutosh. I'm currently staying in Amanora in Pune area. So I'm looking for a 2 to 3 BHK flat to buy a new flat in Magarpatta or Amanora area.
Mm-hmm.
And we are looking for 2 to 3 BHK flat and as an investment.
Okay, what is your budget?
Our budget is around 80 lakhs to 1 crore or 1.2 crore. And we're looking for something, which will appreciate faster. So, but my area is...
Ashutosh, could you mute your TV set? Because that will create disturbance.
Sure.
Right.
Sure,
so, 80 lakh to 1 crore is his budget. He's looking for a 2 or 3 BHK in either Magarpatta or Amanora. Both very attractive locations. What would you say, Surbhi?
Yeah, actually, you know, both the locations are really good. They are both located in Hadapsar area, which is a good commercial hub. Lot of ITIS companies are located here. Even the Kharadi area is nearby. So Magarpatta and Amanora, both are surrounded by employment hub. So it's a good investment bet for a long-term investment. Again, the rental yield in this location is very good. 2-3 BHK property in a 95 lakh to 1 crore is a decent budget.
Right.
So I think you can go ahead and you can see a decent appreciation.
Right. Ashutosh, do you plan to rent out this property?
Yeah, I mean, the rent.
Let me ask Surbhi this. Surbhi, if he does plan to rent out this property, like he said, so what would you recommend? Should he go for a 2 BHK or a 3 BHK? Which is the ticket size that is really moving in this market?
Okay, see, in Pune market, in any ITIS kind of market, where there is a lot of workers from ITIS company, a 2 BHK make more sense. Because first, the rental yield is little higher for a smaller configuration. There is more demand for 2 BHK. So I think it is better. If you are looking for rent out, I think go for a 2 BHK property.
Okay, so go for a 2 BHK, that will give you a better rental yield, and that is also a more liquid property if you do plan to sell it off in future, right? Let's move on. We have another call on the line. I'm told Ganesh has called in. Ganesh?
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, welcome to Property Hotline. Tell us what's your question.
Rodopali mein ma'am, maine dukan ek purchase kiya tha. To uske bare mein mujhe puchna tha ki 3 saal ka udhar ka view kaise rahega?
ठीक है
उसको रखूं या 3 साल में बेच दूं मतलब
आपने कब खरीदा था ये
6-7 मंथ्स हो गए मैम
6-7 महीने हो गए और 3 साल तक आप इसको आपको यही जानना है कि 3 साल के लिए होल्ड करें या अभी तुरंत बेच दें
एग्जैक्टली हां
व्हाट वुड यू से सुरभि रोड पाली
ओके सी फॉर अ कमर्शियल इन्वेस्टमेंट फॉर दिस काइंड ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट यू शुड प्लान लॉन्ग टर्म So I think you should hold for 3 more years and see a good appreciation. In between, you can rent it out this property. And in the commercial, you get a good rental yield also. For this kind of property, you can easily get 8-10% yield. So I think lease out for some time and then see for a good appreciation.
Lease out for some time. Ganesh ji, kuch samay ke liye ise rent par de dijiye. Kyunki commercial property jo aapne kharida hai, uska matlab hi ye hai ki आपको बेहतरीन किराया यहाँ पर मिल सकता है इसलिए पहले उसे किराए पर दे दीजिए उसके बाद कुछ साल बाद उसे बेचने की कोशिश कीजिए
तो क्या क्या रेट आ सकता है 3 साल के आसपास मुझे
3 साल के बाद अगर आप बेचते तो कितना अप्रिसिएशन मिल सकता है सुरभि व्हाट वुड यू से रोड पाली व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अप्रिसिएशन कैन यू एक्सपेक्ट दिस इज इन द नवी मुंबई एरिया वेयर वी आर सीइंग अ लॉट ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कमिंग इन
Yeah, because of that, you know, this all the nodes in Navi Mumbai are seeing around 10-12% of appreciation. So that kind of appreciation, YOY, you can look for.
Okay, 10-12%, 10-12% ki badhat ki aap umeed kar sakte hain yahan par. Lekin hold zarur kijiyega, 2-3 saal hold kijiye, kiraye par chadhaiye, uske baad use bechne ki koshish kijiye. Surbhi, before we move on, just a couple of questions because, you know, a lot of people think of buying a shop or in residential areas as investment. What are the things that you need to look out for when you're actually investing in a shop like this?
Okay, see, nowadays it is very popular among people to buy a shop nearby their in their society. So first thing, you need to check whether it is a legal, whether the developer is allowed to build that shop. The legality of the titles, everything is very important. Second thing, what is the end use? If you are planning to rent it out or you are going to be using that property, that is another important thing. Because once the area start growing, then only you will be able to rent it out. So you may have to wait and sit on the property for good 3-4 years until it get constructed, the area become habitable to get the rental returns.
And also, so I think Also, what I wanted to ask you is also that, you know, we know that if it's a residential property and if you kind of furnish it, you probably get a better rental yield. If you were to buy a residential property near an IT hub, like you said, where there are jobs available, you'll probably get a better rental yield. What happens with commercial property? What kind of locations should you ideally be selecting for a commercial property? And, how can you up the rental yield over here?
See, the location matters a lot in this kind of shops. If you are looking for these kind of shops, location really matters. It should be near residential hub. We have to see what are the other, what kind of hub is developing there. So I think these are the few things. Location is very important for a shop.
Right. Location is very important if you're looking to invest in a shop and if you want higher rentals for that particular shop, and ensure that it's near a residential hub. That's a key takeaway coming your way. Let's move on. We have Bhupinder who's called in. Bhupinder, what's your question?
Hey, hi. This is Bhupinder. I'm from Bangalore. Okay.
Yes, Bhupinder. Tell us what's your question.
So my query is I'm looking for investment of around 20 to 30 lakhs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in Bangalore. So I already have a flat in Kadugudi ITPL. Okay, near to ITPL.
Okay.
I'm looking for investment in either South Bangalore or North Bangalore. But I have done some research and it looks like North Bangalore is future, right? So just wanted to know which area would be good and which all properties I should look into. I have done some internal research as well myself.
Right.
So like
right.
CMM Group and People's Property, they have referred me a few projects. I'm mm-hmm. looking for actually that.
Any specific areas that you like in North Bangalore?
Between Manyata Park to New Sales IT Park coming up, that area. So maybe Thanisandra Road or Henur Road.
Thanisandra Road or Henur Road, he's looking at North Bangalore. He thinks that this is the future and he seems to have kind of hit the nail on its head. But tell us, Surbhi, is South Bangalore an equally attractive market?
I will talk about North Bangalore first. A lot of commercial activities are going on. So this area is poised for growth from the commercial development point of view. Thanisandra, Henur Road, these are really a popular location. And once these commercial activity come in into this area, we are expecting a lot of, residential workforce will be moving here. Because OMR and ORR and other locations is already full. There are a lot of people who are looking for alternate location.
Mm.
If we and it is near to the Bangalore airport, this is an added advantage for any firm. If you talk about South Bangalore, that is around Electronic City, I think, it is very far from airport. There are social infrastructure is coming up. So I think there is more potential in North Bangalore. You can even look for upcoming locations like Bagaluru. You can look for Budigere. These are the very affordable kind of location where we are expecting a lot of appreciation. So Thanisandra, Henur Road, Budigere, Bagaluru, and Kugilu, these are all location where you can look for investment.
Right. And Bhupen, if your TV set is switched on right now and if tuned into the show, you can see that we are showing you some charts on your screen. That is a chart of Henur Main Road. The average price is ranging around 5,210 rupees per square foot. And as you can see, rates have gone up 14%. And if I could also ask my team to drop the chart for Thanisandra. Thanisandra has seen rates go up by 7% in the last 1 year. And this, Bhupen, is coming at a time when rates have largely been flat across the country. So, your research is bang on. And like Surbhi said, these are great areas that you can look at. You could also look at Budigere and Bagaluru for affordable housing. Right? Let's take our next caller. Mayur has called in. Mayur?
Yeah, hi. Good evening.
Hi, good evening. What's your question?
Yeah, so I have invested in a portfolio of 3 residential projects. Okay, so the first one being Logics Blossom County in Sector 137, Noida.
Mm-hmm.
That investment was done in 2010.
Okay.
The idea that the project will be completed in 2012.
Mm-hmm.
It is still delayed. I have made all the payments. My entry basic price was about 2,500 per square feet.
Okay.
So I wish to know whether I should hold or sell. The second property is in Noida Extension. That is with Stellar Jeevan. Mm-hmm. The entry was made in January 2012. With an entry point of 2,200 rupees basic selling price.
Okay, Mayur, I'm sorry to interrupt you here. Why don't we just break this down for Surbhi as well? Okay, so let's take up the first one that you said. This is Stellar Jeevan in Noida Extension. Surbhi, he bought it in 2012 for 2,500 rupees per square foot. It is ready to move in right now. Should he hold or should he sell? What would you say?
Okay, in last 5 years, I can say the Noida Extension prices have already doubled. And as he entered the property at 2,200 rupees, now the property price are going in the range of 3,000 to 4,000 rupees a square feet. Now, you know, why the Noida Extension has become so popular? The main reason was affordability. Now that gap is shrinking day by day. So if you compare it with other location, there is a gap of only 500 to 1000 rupees. If you look at Noida nearby market and other upcoming market in Noida. So that gap is shrinking and lot of new supply is going to hit in the market. So already the prices have doubled. I think it is the right time to sell this property. Mm-hmm. And it is better if you sell it before registration.
Right.
Then you can save the registration prices also.
Right, Mayur. So sell this property. Very quickly tell us what's your next property so that Surbhi can tell you what to do with it.
It's Sector 137, Logics Blossom County.
Mm-hmm.
The entry price was 2,500 rupees per square feet, basic selling price. So, all-in price of about 3,000. Entry point was in 2010.
Okay.
And I'm holding it so far.
Okay.
What should I do with it?
Right. Sector 137, Noida. Surbhi, very quickly, if you could tell us, what should he do, hold or sell?
I think he should hold this property because... this area is poised for commercial growth. Recently, a lot of companies like Samsung, KPMG, they have taken large commercial office spaces there. So ultimately, there will be employment in this area. And I think this area is a very well connected through expressway. So I think he should hold this property for a few years because there was reason for these delay. Because of a lot of issue with the things. So, I think better to hold.
Better to hold. Let's move on to your last property. Very quickly, tell us what's that.
It's in Sector 78, Gurgaon. It's in Raheja, Rivanta. These are the low-rise floors.
Hmm.
The entry point was in November 2011 at 4575 rupees per square feet. What should I do with that?
Raheja Revanta, what should he do with this property over there?
Okay, it is nearby the new Gurgaon area of Gurgaon. So the property is well located. It is near NH8. Right now, the situation in Gurgaon is that especially for under construction property in the secondary market, there is a down pricing of around 20 to 25%. So I think... he should hold this property. It is well located property and this is not the right time to sell any property in Gurgaon. If you are not in a financial distress and can hold this property for 2-3 more years, it will give a better return.
Right, Mayur. So sell your first property and hold the other two. You seem to have covered the NCR market for us. Thank you very much for calling in. Let's move on. We have Nagraj who's called in. Nagraj, what's your question?
Thanks for meeting me. I have looking for some investment around 50 lakhs in Karnataka, apart from Bangalore. Do you have any choice, any other location, any other city, apart from Bangalore? Because Bangalore, most of the places, the price is going high. So I'm looking around the longer term, a better investment in other smaller cities, apart from Bangalore.
Right. Very interesting question there, Surbhi. 50 lakh investment. But he doesn't want to invest in Bangalore. Where can he invest within Karnataka?
Okay, within Karnataka, there are other cities like Mangaluru and Shivamoga where he can make an investment. But as per expert, my advice is that you should look for the peripheral areas in Bangalore. And you can very well find a property in this budget of 50 lakh because a lot of area are poised for growth in Bangalore, especially in peripheral area. So North Bangalore is one of the option for you. if you see the commercial market in Bangalore, it is number one right now. It is around 13.5 million square feet of commercial office space has been leased this year. So I think Bangalore has a very good potential, especially the North Bangalore.
Okay. So look at the peripheral areas of Bangalore. Though if you have made up your mind, you do not want to look at Bangalore altogether, you can look at Mangaluru and Shivamoga. Now, both these cities, I believe, are also on the smart city list. So that should help you over there, right? So let's move on. We have Tushar, who's written in through email. Now, Tushar wants to know which are the areas in Pune that can give a rental yield of around 3%. We have a bunch of interesting questions on the show tonight, Surabhi. Rental yield of around 3%. Let's break down what is rental yield first for all those viewers who've tuned in. If you could just tell us how to really calculate that, and why is it important to look at rental yield when you are buying property to invest in?
See, rental yield is the return you are getting per month for your residential property. So, in entire India, the residential yield is around 2 to 3%. Mm-hmm. So, I think you should focus more on location and the developer and the quality of the project. So, these are the few things which can improve the yield little bit. Again, one factor which is very important to get a yield nowadays in cities like Pune, 1 BHK and 2 BHK apartments get better rental yield because of their high demand and configuration. So I think you better focus on a project, better focus on a quality of the project, amenities, and quality of the apartment, right? Then you will get a better rental yield.
So within Pune, which areas would you recommend? Very quickly, if you could tell us, we're running out of time here. Within Pune, which areas would give a high rental yield?
Okay, any area which is near commercial hub, like Kharadi, your Hadapsar. So all these areas will get a better yield. It always depends on developer, and yield is around 2-3% in residential. So you cannot do much better than that, but yes, you can get a better one by doing all these things in any location.
Look at places where there are jobs. That's where you'll get a higher rental yield. Look at Kharadi and Hadapsar if you're in Pune. With that, we are completely out of time on today's edition of Property Hotline. Thank you so much, Surabhi, for joining in, and we hope to see more of you on the show. We'll be back tomorrow, though, with another guest who'll answer some more queries related to buying, selling, or investing in property. You know how to reach out to us with your questions. You can write in on email, on Facebook. You can also send in video queries like you saw today. Send them to feedback@mbnow.in. You can also tweet to me. And you, or if you don't do all of that, you could just call in like all the other callers you saw on the show. We'd love to hear from you. So keep those questions coming in and keep watching Magicbricks Now. Thank you very much for watching.